Would you like to know how Indian princess was welcomed by the Korean king Suro? You will surely be excited after knowing it. In the 24th year of Kianwu of Gwanguti, in the later Han period, in the year of the monkey, 49 AD, on the 27th day of the 7th month, the 9 chief courtiers of King Suro repaired to the palace and were received in royal audience. "It is not good for the king to be alone," they said. "Let your majesty choose the most beautiful and virtuous maiden from among the girls whom we shall bring to the palace and make her your queen." "I was sent down from heaven to rule this land," the king replied. "And so my spouse will also descend from heaven at divine command. Sail towards Mongsan-do in the south and see what happens." The courtiers obeyed. When they were far out at sea, a ship with a red sail and flying a red flag appeared on the horizon, darting toward the north like an arrow. The Kaya sailors waved torches and made signs for the mysterious ship to come near. When it did so, they found that a beautiful princess was on board. The sailors escorted her to the shore, where a courtier mounted a swift steed and galloped off to convey the news to the king. The king was exceedingly glad. He commanded the 9 senior courtiers to meet the princess on the seashore and conduct her to the palace. The courtiers proceeded to the coast and encountered the princess. "Welcome, princess," they said. "The king desires you to enter the palace and be received in audience immediately." "You are strangers," the princess modestly replied. "I cannot follow you, nor can I be so unmaidenly as to enter the palace without due ceremony." The courtiers conveyed the princess' words to the king, and he was struck by her virgin modesty and queenly dignity. He ordered a tent pitched in front of his detached palace on a hill 60 feet southwest of the royal residence and awaited her arrival. The princess left her ship with her suite, which consisted of the 2 courtiers, Sinpo and Chokwong, their wives, Mojong and Moryang, and 20 slaves who carried gold, silver, jewels, silk brocade and tableware in countless boxes as her trousseau. When she reached the top of the hill, she changed her brocade trousers and offered them as a gift to the mountain spirit. Then she approached the tent and the king rose to meet her. The king bestowed native costumes and jewels upon the suite and bade them rest on beds covered with embroidered quilts and pillows. Then he and the princess entered the sleeping chamber. This is presented from Ilion's Chinese Samguk Yuza. Here is the English translation of Legends and History of the 3 Kingdoms of Ancient Korea by Ha Tie Hong and Grifton K. Mintz.